here today, I'm spinning for walleye, and I'm fishing a point. But really I'm on top, right on top of the humpback part at the tip of the point, so I can cast in any direction, and I should have fish. You know, the easiest way to feel is throw it straight down with the boat. And I let it sink all the way to the bottom. Bam, I feel it hit the bottom. And I just crank it up off the bottom. Crank it up off the bottom. You know, and if we just crank it up off the bottom, pick up the line. Pitched my spoon out, started spooning around the boat, and all of a sudden there was weight on it. Oh. 18 incher. Got a 1 ounce bank spoon on because the wind's blowing Mach 10. I like to rig my spoon with a leader that's 30 pound mono. Put the swivel up here instead of attaching to a swivel on the spoon itself. I use braid. And it seems like if you just try to braid straight to the spoon, a lot of times the spoon, when you cast it out 100 feet and crank it a couple times, the spoon will flip up and grab your line. Then you got to reel it all the way in and untangle it. I think the stiffer line helps. I don't think the manufacturer intended it to be that way and will probably differ with me. But anyway, that's how I use it. It makes it a lot easier. On the drop, I felt a little tick on the drop, so I slammed into it. Wow, that's a little way out there. Yeah, now I ain't really fighting like a walleye. one disadvantage to having a long net handle right there. But anyway, I don't know, look like probably 17, 18 inch walleye. He's a little badass because he just hit a spoon bigger than himself. Anyway, he's a little cutie.